please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Hi, welcome back. Well, we're going to discuss the infrastructure sector in great detail. It's on our minds as the government spending has risen in February, while the NHAI road award activity was around the strongest levels ever in the month of March. We have a whole host of guests joining us now on our show. Vinayak Chatterjee, the chairman of Feedback Infra, joins us with the wish list the sector has for FY19. Teena Vermani of Kotak Securities is also with us, and in a bit we'll get some more guests on board. Thank you for joining us. Vinayak, good morning. I just want to start off the discussion with you. You know, we're seeing an uptick in a lot of macro indicators, as we just highlighted, but is it pointing to a recovery, a definitive recovery, or is it too soon to tell?
Well, there is certainly a sweet spot in the economy where government expenditure is kicking in. So companies who are in the business of supplying goods and services to areas where public expenditure has kicked in very well are in a sweet spot. I mean, this has got to do with national highways, it has got to do with electricity transmission and distribution, it has got to do with railways, and it has also got to do with irrigation in many states. Now, and a certain resurgence in urban infrastructure. Cities and towns are all, because of the smart city buzz, are all developing a lot of new projects, whether it's metro rail or multi-level car parks across the spectrum. So there's a lot of buzz in city infrastructure also. So when you add up all of this, you will find that the bulk of this is government expenditure, and there are a clutch of companies who are providers of goods and services who are in what I would call this infra public expenditure sweet spot right now, and they are the companies to watch.
Okay. Good morning, Mr. Chatterjee. If you can tell us, you know, we get kind of contrary views from the government and the NHAI. The NHAI seems to be falling behind in terms of the target set by the government. Composite, do you think that the road ordering has been as per the promise made in the Bharatmala or earlier? Has it fallen short?
You know, this falling short, is it up to target? Is it beyond target? Is a question that all of you in the media are always prone to ask. If you see the sector, I mean, in a particular month or in a particular quarter, there are cycles. But if you see the long-term trend of awards and construction, there is no question that it is going up. It's going up very, very significantly. So I would avoid any questions of this month versus last month, this quarter versus last quarter. See the long-term trend, and it is very clear that when in the last 1 or 2 years of the UPA government, the road construction had fallen to as low as 2 kilometers a day, around 2014. Mm. Now, today, depending on which estimate you believe has the highest level of accuracy, and I don't want to get into that, road construction today is anywhere between 20 to 25 kilometers a day and poised to cross 30. Now, that is the secular trend that we're talking about, and that is very, very healthy. So all companies who are in that sector are benefiting.
Okay. We also get much less data on state government ordering. Can you give us an idea of, you know, central government, at least NHAI puts out some figures, but can you give us some idea of how much of state government ordering has happened in the past years?
I don't have hard statistics with me. Mm. But I do know that in from my colleagues in our own company's road division, there is significant activity in state road corporations, whether it's Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, MSRDC, etc., etc. So there is significant action. And I would certainly add that at higher levels than we have seen in the past, when you sigma all the states together, but if you ask me for hard statistics, state by state, who's doing what, or I don't have that readily with me.
Okay, that's fine. We also have Rohan Suryavanshi, the head strategy and planning of Dilip Buildcon. So Dilip Buildcon basically benefits from all of these orders, right? Rohan is here with us in the studio. Rohan, good morning. The company has been getting a lot of orders off late, but tell us, you know, are there more in the pipeline? What's the visibility looking like?
Yes, good morning. So the company's obviously had a very good year, FY18, and we managed to secure about 19,500 crores of new order book, which was higher than the total order book that we had last year.
So, which was
17,500. Okay. So today, now the company has about an order book of about 28,000-29,000 crores. So this gives us a visibility for the next three to 4 years. Mm-hmm. But you know, what has been the trend for the company in the past few years, that we'll be able to do these projects before time. Okay. Now for this year, given that this is an election year and the fact that the government's already announced a higher budgetary allocation for the road sector, mm-hmm. we are very, very confident that they are going to be awarding a higher number of orders this year as opposed to last year. Mm-hmm. Also, what will happen is, unlike last year and even, you know, to some extent the year before that, mm. A lot of orders were just came at the end of the financial year. Mm. We feel that this year a lot of orders are going to come throughout the year as well, unlike just the, you know, one-ended order flow that happened at the end of the financial year.
Can you add some more color to what we were discussing with Vinayak Chatterjee?
Yeah.
Are you seeing ordering by the state governments? I mean, compared to what it was, say, 2 years ago?
Absolutely. I think governments across the country have woken up to the fact that this is the best way, not just to showcase the kind of work that they're doing, but also to stimulate the economy. So whether it was, you know, an Akhilesh government back in UP, when they came out, their election mantra was Kaam Bolta Hai. So why they're doing, why all state governments have woken up, this is a very, very easy way to showcase that we were doing stuff. Mm-hmm. So besides the NHAI and the MORTH ordering, like Mr. Chatterjee also pointed out, there is enough number of state government ordering that is happening across different states. Mm-hmm. And I would say that would be, it would be nearly an amount of what the NHAI and MORTH is ordering.
Okay. For the first time, we heard someone saying that they have executed an order before the deadline. Mm-hmm. I think Dilip Bilkon told the exchanges recently about an order getting executed. Can you tell us about that? And is it that execution is easier for any specific reason? Are projects coming already with environment and land approvals?
So nothing has really changed in terms of, clearances. Yeah, yeah. So all of those things, the status quo that is for us, it's the same for every other construction company. The issues that come up in land acquisition or environmental or forest, we are a product of that same ecosystem. However, what's different for us is the fact that we are very, very vertically integrated. Mm. We do everything on our own. You know, the model that we follow, in terms from starting from the due diligence of the projects to the way that we execute it using our own equipment, having our own people, to the way that they monitor them. All of it put together helps us do that. And it's not just the few orders that you saw recently that we did before time. If you look at our last 5 years, we won an early completion bonus of about 320 odd crores. And this is, I'm talking about till FY17. This has been a consistent performance by the company, that even last year we did about 100 crores of early completion bonus, which is unheard of for any other company in the sector.
Okay. In fact, there's someone who tracks your stock very closely. Teena Vermani of Kotak Securities also joins in now into the discussion. Teena, thanks for joining in. You've been hearing both Vinayak and Rohan put their points on board. What's your sense about the growth that this sector could see over the next, say, 3-4 quarters? And what would your top picks be in this space?
We would not be tracking the companies on a quarterly basis because of the lumpy nature of the business and the execution. But when you look at FY19, for all the companies that we are currently covering, we are expecting a 30-40% growth in net profits over FY18, and in FY20, we are expecting another 20-25% over the base of FY19. So that's the kind of growth in profitability that we are expecting for the companies that we are covering.
Okay.
And that's mainly led by a sharp jump in execution.
Okay. Most of the infrastructure companies or construction companies had a problem of balance sheet. Do you think that many have overcome that, or are you sticking with those that never got into a hole?
No, actually, if you see the entire sector, the sector is in a much better position as far as balance sheet related issues are concerned.
I see.
Balance sheets are much leaner. The leverage has come down drastically for the sector because companies have hived off either their non-core assets or low return yielding assets. And the working capital is also manageable. And with the kind of inflow that we have received in last financial year, there would be a significant amount of customer advances also. Mm-hmm. So with that way, the balance sheet does not pose a problem for the company, and funding is also not a constraint for all the players like DBL, IRB, NCC, Simplex. So funding should not be a constraint for these companies for meeting the equity requirements so far. And if we see a similar kind of inflow for FY19 also, then we may expect some kind of funding requirements to be raised via market by various companies. But so far, for the current order book, companies are fairly positioned to meet the requirements.
Okay, this is actually music. We always thought, at least we thought up until a minute ago, that infrastructure companies are unable to borrow and nobody lends to them. The infrastructure space with Rohan Suryavanshi, the strategy head of Dilip Buildcon, Vinayak Chatterjee, chairman, Feedback Infrastructure, and Teena Vermani of Kotak Securities. And the last we heard from Teena is that balance sheets are not all that broken. There are several companies that are able to go ahead and put in equity, and that banks and funds are available. Mr. Chatterjee, is the situation changing in terms of availability of finance for infra?
Well, to be frank with you, there are two sets of players in the infrastructure sector. For a minute, let's just talk about the road sector, because power sector is far more complicated. In the road sector, there are a large number of fairly large and well-known construction companies who had got deeply into the BOT space, or they had become big developers. They are still struggling with legacy issues and in terms of deleveraging their balance sheets and cleaning up sometimes NPAs and sometimes high debt burdens. There is, if you see the list of NHAI projects awarded in recent times, it is interesting to see a crop of 7 to 10 names who have suddenly risen to the top of order booking and order books, who historically had not been great participants or even well-known national brands in the BOT development space. So there are clearly two classes of balance sheets.
Okay.
One that are still stressed and have legacy issues and are not particularly enthusiastically participating in the new bids, and the others which are fast moving, fast running, smaller and medium sized companies of 3 or 4 or 5 years ago who have risen to the top in the EPC.
Whom the banks are willing to lend?
Yeah. Yes, because their balance sheets are reasonably clean.
Fair.
PE funds are keen to participate in the equity structure of the company or on SPVs, and banks and other institutions are willing to lend because their order books are attractive and healthy. Okay. The balance sheets are clean, so there should be no hesitation in lending.
Okay, so we've spoken in great detail about roads and railways, but another pocket I wanted to talk about was water infrastructure, more importantly, irrigation, river linking projects, etc. Rohan, you were telling us earlier that ordering from state governments has picked up quite a bit in this river linking projects. Are you guys bidding for any, and is that a space that's opening up quite a bit?
Yes, that is a space that the government, especially the national government, is very keen on, that they want to give out more and more projects in this. And this was a pet project even for the erstwhile Vajpayee government. Mm. Unfortunately, it kept on getting stuck in legal tangles, and eventually there was a Supreme Court judgment which said we need to go ahead with this, irrespective of the environmental consequences or what we supposed to be, might be, okay, might, you know, the consequences of that. So that has been the go, it was given the go-ahead by the apex court. Unfortunately, nothing really came up in that big way. However, now the minister specifically is very, very keen on these projects and these projects coming out. So we are also awaiting how the ordering will eventually shape out. But there are a bunch of good, interesting projects, and that's a large, large space as well where they're looking to invest a big sum of money.
Okay. Well, finally, just one word on power. I know we won't do any justice to it, but Mr. Chatterjee, one worries that a large number of them could go into the NCLT because of the Reserve Bank order that stressed projects of over 2,000 crore, if not resolved, should be taken to the NCLT. What's the next in the power sector? Do you see many of them going in for auction, getting auctioned?
Look, the sector requires very serious restructuring intervention. Mm-hmm. For a long time now, I have argued with anybody who's willing to listen to me, from PMO to the Energy Ministry to think tanks, that the center needs to step into a big way to set up a national power distribution company to pick up all the stranded capacity that state government discoms are not picking up. The country has power production capacity. The plants are in good shape. The absence of a buyer is leading to plant load factors of 59% or so. A massive central intervention picking up stranded power capacities could actually cure 90% of the ills of the sector. But somebody has to bite the bullet.
Okay. Well, we will discuss that on another day. For the moment, we have run out of time. Vinayak Chatterjee, Teena Vermani and Ruhan Suryavanshi. Thank you very much for joining us. Well, we're picking up a lot of optimism from this conversation that at least road construction and water projects are on the upswing. There are several companies that are willing to pick up orders and get finance. We wrap up Bazaar on a positive note for the bulls as well. A lot of